Hello, in this video I want to present a few points about symbology, including ways of symbolizing highways with shield symbols. I've got the Tippecanoe County data up on the map in front of me. I've decluttered it a little bit from perhaps what you've been looking at. One of the things that does annoy us is when features don't have colors that represent what they truly are. For example, I have water here that's green, and that was the default color. I added the layer to the map and it just defaulted to a green color. We really want you to be looking and thinking about that kind of thing, and when we see a map from you, we want to have the water be blue, for example. We would expect that schools have been symbolized with a school symbol, or that railroads have been symbolized with a railroad symbol. So, that said, I want to differentiate maybe these big highways and symbolize them. Probably I would want to do one of these kind of highway lines. That looks too cluttered to me, so I choose not to do that because of the scale of the map that I'm at. So it kind of depends. If I was going to blow this map way up, then that double yellow line might be quite appropriate. Too much still, to my eye. So to symbolize the highways, there's a couple different ways, as there is for everything in ArcGIS. I can go to Symbology, and I can go to labels, and this shows because I was here a second ago. Label styles let you pick something like that, and let's use this. What this is going to do is it's going to label all of them this way. So this is not going to be the way you want to do it for this particular project. And okay, what number goes in here is controlled by the label field that we have up here. So if I use name, I'm going to get a label that's basically too long. See how that it sticks out, State Road 126. So this particular file, because we've used it for so many years, has been shortened. I have a field called SName, which stands for short name, that has just the numerical digit of the state and federal highways. So if I use that one as the field, then it fits inside of the shields, or at least mostly it does. Now, again, that's hitting all the ones in the layer, and it's hitting every segment for each road, which is too much in this sense. So I'm turning label fields off. So the other way to label is with the click to label. So I can use the label tagging tool, but I don't see it on my toolbars right now because the floating toolbars are minimized. I've turned it off. So I would probably have to either experiment turning them on or remember that it's on my drawing toolboard. So underneath the text and other labels, we have what I call the price tag one. It automatically find best placement, or no, place the label at the place I click. That's what I want to do. And I'm going to choose my style. So I'm going to choose the interstate, and I'm going to tag the interstate with it, I-65. And remember, because I set this text is coming from the short name field, so it looks nice. And then the other ones are state highways, or I'm sorry, they're federal. And so I'm going to tag them Highway 52 in various. Oh, I don't want that one, so let's get rid of it. So I didn't, when I cleaned up my fields, I did not clean every single field. So I have to hit delete. So we have various years, we have various requirements on how many you should tag, but that helps you, you can symbolize them. I can tag other features that way, and it will draw from the label field and place on the screen whatever I'm tagging. And I think that concludes this movie.